The White House is proposing significant cuts to the National Oceanic and Atmospheric Administration. That's the federal agency responsible for monitoring the nation's weather and climate. The plan would cut the agency's $6 billion budget by more than 25%. KCCI meteorologist Zane Satry tells us what those changes could mean.
The most dramatic cuts would be to NOAA's Office of Oceanic and Atmospheric Research. NOAA currently runs 10 research labs across the country. It funds 16 institutes at various universities, 6 regional climate centers, and other research programs. The proposed budget would reduce NOAA's research funding by almost 75% and eliminate its research office altogether. Some programs would remain, like severe weather and radar research, and would move to the National Weather Service. Now, the National Weather Service itself would be funded at 2024 levels, a budget of about $1.2 billion. Now, you might remember hundreds of the Weather Service's roughly 5,000 employees were fired earlier this spring, and a similar number are expected to take buyouts, further reducing services like weather balloon launches. Now, what effects could you notice from all these changes? The most immediate one would be a loss of information. Much of the historical weather data we analyze and share with you every week comes from NOAA's climate centers, which would be defunded. For example, the Midwest Regional Climate Center, which tailors a lot of its data towards agriculture, recently went dark for multiple days when its funding lapsed. That would likely become permanent if these proposals become reality. And NOAA's research labs have also been responsible for many of the scientific advancements in areas like computer modeling, hurricane prediction, flood forecasting, and radar. Much of that work would end. Now, so far, this plan is just a proposal and would require approval from Congress.
And you will be able to read more of the proposed changes and the budget memo itself on KCCI.com.